तमसो मा सद्गमय तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय मृत्योर्मा अमृतं गमय ॐ शांति 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 ॐ मे द डिवाइन लीड अस फ्रॉम द अनरियल टू द रियल फ्रॉम डार्कनेस टू लाइट From death to immortality. Om, peace, peace, peace.
A prayer to Mother Kali by Komala Kanto. Ever blissful, enchanting Mother Kali, who is eternally dancing, singing, and clapping in her own glory.
Shodanandamayi Kali Maha. Namahi kali mahakali unmohini shodananda mohi kali apne naacho apne gaao ma apne naacho apne gaao ma apne
Adibhuta Shonatuni
I'm reading from the book Sister Nivedita by Pravarajika Atma Prana. Here the chapter is Kali and Kali worship. One day when an image of Kali was brought before Sister Nivedita, she said to Swami Vivekananda, "Perhaps Swamiji, Kali is the vision of Shiva. Is she?" He looked at her for a moment and gently said, "Well, well, express it in your own way." And beautifully she described her in the vision of Shiva as follows. Her mass of black hair flows behind her like the wind, or like time, the drift and passage of things. But to the great third eye, even time is one, and that one, God. She is blue, almost to blackness, like a mighty shadow, and bare, like the dread realities of life and death. But for him, there is no shadow. Deep into the heart of that most terrible, he looks unshrinking, and in the ecstasy of recognition, he calls her mother. So shall ever be the union of the soul with God. The Swami, that Swami Vivekananda, called the worship of Kali the worship of death. Her terrible form at other times of her beneficent form, Nivedita struggled hard to understand this concept of the Universal Mother, but gradually by her Guru's grace, that is Swami Vivekananda's grace, she understood it. He, as it were, gave her the key to this understanding. Many were surprised at her devotion to Kali the Terrible. One day when she was engrossed in her thoughts, she saw that a short red road led up to Kali. But as she got nearer and nearer, Kali went backward further and further, till she became a lofty black door. It was the end of the path, and beyond lay the infinite ocean. And Sister Nivedita understood that Kali was death. Constant meditation on Mother Kali had become so natural with Nivedita that till the end of her life, she felt the presence of the power that Kali symbolized. The editor of the Hindu Review had once been to her house and wrote about this interesting interview with her as follows. "Once I was sitting with Nivedita in her house in Bhospara Lane, sipping tea out of her quaint Swadeshi cups. Suddenly the sky was overcast with black scowling clouds, as oftentimes happens in our early summer evenings. And there was immediately a marked change in the mood of my hostess," that is Nivedita. "Her face seemed at once to reflect this awfully dynamic mood of nature. It beamed with a new light, at once awful and lovely. and she sat silent, apparently unconscious for the moment of my presence, looking intently through the window at the gathering gloom about the earth and the heaven and listening, like one in a trance, to the rising tumult of the growing storm. And just as there came, in a little while, the first flash of lightning, followed by the crash of the first thunder, she cried out with bated breath, "Kali." Here is reading.
Now a short period of meditation. Welcome to the Sunday service, and again we are with Mother Kali. It was on 4th, 11th, and also today, 4th, 11th, and also today on Mother Kali, because the Kali Puja was on 4th, and Sundays we are having talks on that, meditation, and today the talk. So, Vedanta Society, worshipping Mother Kali, the organization whose core is Vedanta philosophy, loving Kali so much, which looks to be terrible, the form is terrible, the woman black in color with tongues out and a decapitated head and the sword. What Vedanta has to do with the Kali? It seems very, they're so opposite poles, but without Kali, Vedanta doesn't exist. Not only because Sri Ramakrishna reached the ultimate truth through love of Kali, but he also said, one has to love Kali and propitiate her if you want to know the truth, if you want to realize God. Without her making you the way, it is very, very difficult by not recognizing her to reach the truth. Truth is beyond this manifested universe. It is inconceivable, it is unbound, uncaused, it is beyond time's cause and thing, substance. But that reality, desha kala nimitta, beyond that, that reality has to be attained by worshipping Kali, by propitiating Kali, by loving Kali. Beautiful song, describing the mother, how Kamala Kanta, who is a real lover of Mother Kali, how goes it, Mother, she describes Mother Kali in the form of having the, that we worship, and they are going beyond that form. And he says, oh mother, you are of this form, as we see in the image or photograph, and yet you wear the garland of skulls. How did you get that when there was no universe? You had not created. How could you get, you know, the human skull will come after human beings are created. But how you get, got that? Because you are eternal. Just looks the form and goes beyond and knows that Kali is the eternal reality. And his expression of wonderful, you are all destroyer, wielding the sword in your hand. And you have taken away my dharma and adharma. You have all removed my dharma and also adharma along with dharma. I am beyond any thought, any responsibility of this world. Sri Krishna also said in the Gita, sarva dharman parityajya, dharma, adharma, everything you give up. Adharma nobody wants to practice. Adharma is a non-righteousness. Dharma is the righteousness, the good thing. Don't think about that. Take refuge in me. I will let you know after you take refuge in me what you should do, what is real dharma. When you surrender to me, O Arjuna, then I will make you work according to divine will, not your egoistic will. And then that will be nothing but the great dharma. You don't have to consider the dharma that your ego has understood, your scriptures have taught. What I will guide you, being an instrument in my hands, by totally surrendering to me, you will be in my hands, my instrument, my dear child. Then don't worry for what is right or what is wrong. Just surrender yourself fully to me. Done. That's what Kamala Kanta, the great lover of Mother Kali, also said the same thing. Thore Oshi, Sarva Nashi Thore Oshi, Munda Mala, Thore Oshi, Dharma Dharma Dude Kheli. You ate up my all adharma, of course, by your love. Even my dharma, what should I do, it's also gone. There is no my individual existence, all only in you. You really worth with the sword, and as it is said, Mother Kali's sword is to destroy. But what she destroys? She destroys ignorance. That is called, that's why it's called Jnana Khadga. The Khadga which gives us knowledge, that's Mother Kali's sword. So, the Vedanta society worshipping Mother Kali. What is the relationship? Many Vedanta places you won't see so much love for Mother Kali. So, Vedanta and Kali, that is the topic today. Vedanta is the philosophy which enables us to reach the ultimate truth. Vedanta's message is faith, fearlessness, and service. When this service aspect comes, then Kali is there. Kali is the ultimate power, the supreme energy that creates this universe. And we see the variation here. We live in this world as individual being. That is Kali. When we think of creation and preservation, and of course destruction will be there, and when we are not afraid of destruction, when we are not afraid of death, then has Mother Kali really come. When we love only this created universe and temporal existence here, Mother Kali we leave, no doubt, but we have not understood Kali, because we are fearful. With the worship of Kali or practice of Vedanta, fearlessness must come. Death comes, Swami Vivekananda used to say, someone asked me, Swamiji, what do you will teach me? I will teach you how to love death. As in Sister Nivedita's reading, that was read, beautiful, Sister Nivedita, how she grew up in accepting Kali as the death coming. Swami Vivekananda used to say, I feel strong, but when I feel death comes, I become very, very strong. And he struck the stone in his two hands and said that, my all fear goes when I see death is approaching. Death is not something to be avoided, something to be afraid. It is to be embraced. It is to be not fearful and fled away. Death will come one day. And it's not that terrible as it is thought. Because of our attachment to the world and clinging to this life, which we call so-called life, temporary life, is not real life. Our life is eternal life. And as Sri Krishna said in the Gita, this life is eternal. Only in the short time it manifested as human individuality. And you call that as your existence, then you are totally mistaken. Your existence is eternal. Only you are now appearing as human existence. That is the thing. It is for the time being and very short time compared to your eternal continuous life. With birth it didn't start life, with death the life will not end. The life, the consciousness is eternal thing. So Vedanta teaches us to be faith, to have faith and to be fearless, attain fearlessness and live in this world with attitude of service. A beautiful verse in Mandukya Upanishad, that shortest Upanishad and beautiful Advaita thought. It said, the nature of reality says, Nantah pragyam na bahish pragyam, no bhayatah pragyam, na pragyana ghanam, na pragyam, na apragyam, adristam, avyavaharyam, agrahyam, alakshanam, achintyam, avyapadeshe, desham, ekatma, pratyasaram, prapancho, pasamam, shantam, shivam, चतुर अद्वैतम चतुर्थम मन्यन्ते स आत्मा स विज्ञेय. That is Atman, that is to be known, that is to be attained, says Vedanta. What is that? They consider, the one who has realized, the Rishi who is saying in Mandukya, he says, not I am saying you. This has been told earlier by many seekers, many who have realized God. I just corroborate that to you, that I also have experienced that, and I am saying not my word, but I am relating what they have said. It has been said by many. So consider this to be truth. Realization is realizable. Not that only I have realized. They consider the fourth to be that. Fourth is the stage, which is not waking, which is not dreaming, which is not deep sleep. Then these are the three stages we experience. There is a fourth stage, that is the stage of super consciousness. And that fourth is called Turiya, that is Brahman, that is the reality. The fourth to be that which is not conscious of the internal world, nor conscious of the external world. The fourth in the supreme reality, there is no world at all. Nothing of this transaction, no body, no mind, no individual existence, no ego, nothing is there. It is just you are there. You without any experience of anything. That is the fourth state. And there is no internal world, there is no outer world. Internal world is dream world, outer world is the world when we are awake. There is nothing of that in that fourth state. Nor conscious of both the worlds. So fourth state is not at all conscious of anything. Nor a mass of consciousness, pragyana ghanam. It's mass of, the fourth state is indescribable. That's what it means, negated everything. Nor simple consciousness, that awareness that we have. That will be something we'll be understanding there, something I'm pure, I'm not related, I was never born. Nothing of that. Whatever we can think of what that fourth state is, that all is being negated in this. What is that? Only it can be said one thing, it is Sat-Chit Ananda. It is there, it is awareness, consciousness, and it is blissful. That alone can be said about the fourth state. Anything that we relate to the world with outer, inner consciousness, awareness, solidified, simple, nothing is there in that fourth state. That is what Vedanta wants to say. Nor unconsciousness, of course, there is no unconsciousness, as we have unconsciousness of our intellect and mind in the deep sleep, which is, then it says, which is unseen beyond empirical dealings, beyond the grasp of the organs of action, uninferable, you cannot prove, you cannot say this is Brahman, unthinkable. यतो वाचो निवर्तन्ते अप्राप्य मनसा सह. So the speech wanted to talk about the realization of the person, but it returned before reaching there along with mind. Mind cannot reach, speech cannot express, but you can become that. You are that, Tattvamasi. That's what Vedanta subject is. Unthinkable, indescribable. Mind doesn't go, speech cannot work. Nothing worth of that state. Which valid proof consists in the single belief in the self. But you are, you know, bujhe pran, bujhe jar. Only one who has experience knows that the truth, but he cannot or she cannot tell that. Only the self is the proof. In this valid proof, it consists in the single belief in the self, in which all phenomena sees, phenomena is this multifarious universe that we experience, and which is unchanging, auspicious and non-dual. Shivam Shantam Shivam Prapancho Upasamam means Prapancha is this universe. Whatever we perceive in the universe is Prapancha. Upasamam means nothing is there of this universe. That's why Prapancha Upasamam. Then Shantam Shivam Advaitam Chaturtham. So this fourth state that first is started with from this Chaturtha year, it says Shantam Shivam Advaitam. It is peace. What peace? Not the peace that we experience here. It is the supreme peace. Peace that passeth understanding, says the Bible. The peace that we understand, it goes beyond that. So that is experienced as peace and shantam and shivam, auspiciousness. It is something that is so noble. So one wants to have that, so auspicious, pure, it is so too close to the heart, so much every human being, every soul wants to realize that. That is so auspicious. And Advaitam, non-dual, there is no I and you, there is only one. That state, I am realizing you, O Brahman, is not there. Only Brahman is there, only Atma is there. That is the self. That is myself. What I say, I am myself. We say to the body, sometimes to the mind. But myself is that fourth state. That is the self, and that is to be known. Until we know that, we have known nothing. And to know that, we'll have to be reborn again and again, and we'll be in the darkness. So we have to go beyond ignorance to realize that which is indescribable, which is unthinkable, and yet which is Shantam Shivam Advaitam, which is peace, supreme peace, and auspiciousness, non-dual experience. Whatever you say, experience. We say, when you use the term experience, logically you cannot use the word experience, because in experience, the mind experiences something, object, some nice sound, beautiful dream. We also experience our thought. If you go subtle, and the gross matter, of course. There is no thought, there is nothing to experience. Experiencer and experience is not there. All this experiencing and the experiencer and the experience all become one. That's why that is Advaita. That is the search of Vedanta. Vedanta says that has to be known. If you are born as a human being, if you are in this state, you are in a very good state. You have been given that mumukshuttam manushyattvam mahapurusha samsaya. By God's gift you have got that. Mumukshuttam is the desire to know this truth, this shantam shivam advaitam, this satchit ananda. You should know sabhigyaya, says the teacher. It is the thing to be known. All other things known is fine, but unless you know this, you are ignorant. When Yam went to Sri Ramakrishna, Yam asked Sri Ramakrishna, okay, how is you? Are you married? He said, yes, I am married. They said, how is your wife? She is good, but she is ignorant. There was no need to say she is ignorant. what Priyam said, she is ignorant, Ajnan. She said, oh, and then you are the man of knowledge. Sri Ramakrishna retorted back. He was double MA, headmaster of his school, whole society respected him. He was a good teacher and he has a fantastic memory, excellent student career. That person really thought, I know the thing, I'm jnani, I'm learned. And my wife has studied and she is ignorant, illiterate, unlearned. That's what he wanted to say, and he used the term of jnan. And Sri Ramakrishna said in such a way, he said, my ego was just pounded, it was grounded, it was pulverized. That was the thing. And said, I always thought myself to be a man of knowledge and learning, at least learning, no knowledge, but knowledge of the books. And he had studied so many books of philosophy, novels, he had great voracious reader, and really a rare type of person in the society to be so much interested in reading, learning, and thinking also. Had idea of thinking and fantastic memory, great degrees, and wonderful occupation of teaching others. One who teaches is the teacher, so he knows. That's why he teaches. He thought that we all have idea. And Sri Ramakrishna, in one go, like the balloon, he just pricked the balloon and all the air gone. The big balloon became small piece of plastic, rubber. And what is it? And you are a man of knowledge. You consider yourself to be a man of knowledge. Then when he found Sri Ramakrishna saw, he was startled, really. Then Sri Ramakrishna explained, to know God alone is knowledge. When you do not know God, you are ignorant. No difference between you and your wife, how many degrees you may have, and no difference between we and any person who is illiterate, who has no learning. So there is no difference if we see spiritually. So here, Savigya, the person here, all those who came to learn Vedanta, they had already studied and thought and had the Brahmacharya life, and then he says, all is fine, but this is to be known. This is it, that's why he says Savigya. Now, this idea of Vedantic knowledge. Now, how to have this knowledge? Okay, it cannot be known through intellect, and you want us to know that. It cannot be experienced through the mind, and you want us to make to know. How to know this? That is the big problem. Then the Vedantic study is neti neti, deny, negate everything that you see. This is not Brahman. Whatever you see, you experience, this is not Brahman. Neti, neti, neti. There is no positive way to go, iti, no, not that. You just negate everything that you experience. It is not Brahman, it is not God, it is not that. Chaturtham, your three stages are not that. Your body, your mind, your speech, your senses, the people you see around, the universe you see around, the sunset, sunrise, this vast universe with the galaxies and solar systems. Nothing is Brahman. So neti, 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 then the Vedanta says you will reach there. What a difficult path to reach the Vedantic knowledge. Is there any other path? Sri Ramakrishna came and said, yes, there is easier path fitted for the Kali Yuga. You don't have to negate. You say iti, iti. You be in the world, you just propitiate, be love and love Mother Kali. If you love and worship Kali, you will realize Advaita Jnana. That will come to you, says Sri Ramakrishna. So, Kali, what is Kali? Kali is the supreme divine power, the primordial energy who creates, preserves, and destroys this universe of form, color, and mind, intellect, senses, etc. She is the source of our lives. She is the cause of our death. She is the reason of our lively sustenance. So whatever we find is all Mother Kali. We are under the domain of Mother Kali. We are created by her. We live by her arrangement. We are sustained by her. And finally, we also go back to her. She is the source and the goal of our individuality, individual life. That is Mother Kali. So without Mother Kali, we can do nothing. And Totapuri's life is expressed. Totapuri was never believed in Kali or Prakriti or Shakti. He just believed that Neti, he did, and he had found the truth by that way. But he never accepted Mother Kali. And finally, it happened so much stomach ache, this body, which he always negated, he didn't care. And he could negate the body, deny the body, go into the deep spiritual awareness of the Atman. He could go there. But that day what happened, he is not able to go. Body, this pain is bringing back to the Prakriti, to the nature, to this individuality, to this Dvaita. He was not able to establish himself in the Advaita. Chatursam, where Chatursam? All this Dvaita Jagat. And then he thought, let me throw this away body. This body is creating all problem. Let me give up this body and merge in, give me this individuality and merge in the Supreme Being, that is my real nature. And he wanted to himself drown in Ganga. Went to Ganga, walks. No water in Ganga to drown a man. Such a mighty big river, and he is not drowned. Then he thought, something is there, that magic is there. Suddenly it flashed to him, oh, my disciple, that Sri Ramakrishna said, there is Mother Kali, it is all her play, it is all her domain. Even Brahma Jnani person was under the domain of Mother Kali, you see. Then he came to Kali temple, he told Sri Ramakrishna, Sri Ramakrishna brought him to Kali temple, and there he then recited the stotras, and he felt blessed. He said, without mother's will, you cannot even die. You cannot even die. Just they will give up. So that is the Mother Kali. All controller of our life, everything is she. So the only way to reach Brahman is not by negating Mother Kali, but by accepting Mother Kali, by propitiating Mother Kali. Is there any relation between Brahman and Shakti, between Shiva and Kali, between Purusha and Prakriti? This is the, we experience this dual thing. One is Brahman, the ultimate reality, no unthinkable, unworkable, untransactionable, that it is said, prapanchopasamam, there is no prapancha, that ultimate reality, and another is all this prapancha. That is called Kali, and when there is no universe, there is no phenomena, which is called noumena by some, that is Brahman. And between Shiva and Kali, of course we have the idea of Shiva and also idea of Kali. Shiva is the ultimate reality, that Brahman represented in that form, what we see, the void complex and the matted locks and the moon as the, his ornament and the snakes around his neck, Shiva and the Kali. Similarly, there is the idea of Purusha and Prakriti. Purusha is the male principle and Prakriti is that what we see. And these two combined, then the existence is there, Purusha and Prakriti. Otherwise, Prakriti cannot remain alone without Purusha. Kali cannot alone exist without Shiva. And Shakti cannot be there without Brahman. Brahman without Shakti cannot create. Shakti without Brahman has no existence. So that is what the relation that is said. Both they become complementary to each other, Shiva and Shakti. Then the universe comes forth. If Shakti merges in Shiva, then there is no creation. And if Shakti is separate from Shiva, Shakti has no power to create. If there is no Shakti in Shiva, then Shiva has no, cannot create at all. So that's how this philosophy of Shiva and Shakti goes together. So how to know the unthinkable? How to reach the unreachable? How to conceive the unconceivable? So that is the problem. So what is the way? Kali is the way, says the Vedanta. Sri Ramakrishna, Holy Mother, Swami Vivekananda, they all taught that, they lived that. If you accept the Kali, this universe as the manifestation of that Brahman, you will reach that unmanifested Brahman more easily, and that is the only possible way. Sri Ramakrishna said, that which is Shyama is also Brahman. That which has form again is without form. That which has attributes again has no attributes. Brahman is Shakti. Shakti is Brahman. They are not two. They are only two aspects, male and female, of the same reality, existence, knowledge, bliss, absolute. That is the reality, and Brahman and Shakti represent both that reality, and both them represent the same reality. Brahman and Shakti, that's the idea that Sri Ramakrishna, Ma Kali is that. It is not separate from Brahman. Brahman and Kali are same. It is the Shakti that represents. Sri Ramakrishna says, image of Mother Kali standing on Shiva, that are Ardhanarishvara, or conjoined image of Radha and Krishna, that represent that truth, ultimate truth, which is not manifested and this manifested universe. Both are the same, obverse and reverse of one coin. You cannot separate these two. And that's why it is worshipped Ardhanarishvara, half Shiva and half Parvati. That idea is that without that there is no fullness. Fullness is Shiva will always be with Parvati. Brahman will always be with Shakti. There is no existence of Brahman without Shakti. That very existence has power in it, and that power manifests, and that in the presence of Brahman. So, and Sri Ramakrishna says, conjoined image of Radha Krishna. That also represent like Shiva and Shakti, Radha and Krishna, that are also full. With these two it becomes complete, otherwise it is incomplete. Sri Ramakrishna, when he started having the Kali sadhana, first his inquiry, is God real? Is Kali that I worship is a living or just an image? So he found, and one day he was trying to do that, and then he said, if you don't reveal to me, the life is not worth. So he wanted to test and find. And one day, when he was too much in agony to worship something, not to be able to understand, wants to know the truth, the yearning has increased so high level that you do not show me, I won't, then life is worth not living, he thought. And at that moment, he fell on the ground. And he saw that ocean, he himself describes, ocean of life, light came towards me in waves, surging waves, and it drowned me, and I was completely in that ocean of light. What happened in that, I do not know. Sri Ramakrishna cannot describe how he felt in that light. But that was Mother Kali. Mother Kali appeared to him in very Vedantic way. The first appearance of Mother Kali was very Vedantic, formless, in the form of light. In many other sadhakas, Mother really seemed to be a girl that is helping Ram Prasad, or turning the pages of Kamalakanta. Like that happened in many lives, they also had this vision of Mother Kali. But in Sri Ramakrishna's case, it was Mother appeared first as light. After she had the vision of Mother as a little girl that is walking and moving in the courtyard of Dakshineswar, climbing the temple, that he had the vision. But first vision was this, after yearning. Then there was no doubt about the living Mother being there and everywhere. Presence of God was no and not to be doubted. And after a long time he came to consciousness and he uttered the word, Mother, Mother, he uttered. So whether he had the vision of Divine Mother, not known. Because Mother was his Aradhya Devata, Aradhya Devi, you can say. So that was his chosen ideal, was Mother Kali. But Mother Kali didn't appear in that form, showing that his worship of Mother Kali will be different. It will be a very Vedantic way of accepting and worshipping Mother Kali as a means to realize the truth of Vedanta. But you have to reach through Kali. Sri Ramakrishna said, he who is the Purusha is also the Prakriti. Both are the embodiment of bliss. The bliss is ultimate, Satchit Ananda, Ananda Mohi Kali, that was also there. That's why Kali is sometimes said to be in bliss, and dancing in bliss, that concept of Mother Kali is there. That the main aspect of Mother is, it is all bliss. The whole reality is Anandam. Anandam, Shudhu Anandam. That is the reality. If we are deviated from reality, we are not with God. Swami Vivekananda says, first sign of that you are being spiritual is your cheerfulness. Are you happy or you are so sad for, oh, where is God, nothing is there, everything is bad, then you are away from God. Cheerfulness in your life, in every situation, if possible, then God is always with you. Whenever you are worried for the world and you become very disturbed in mind, God is little, you have, God has not gone from away from you, you have come away from God. So, cheerfulness, that ananda, and Sri Ramakrishna says, this Purusha and Prakriti are both the embodiment of bliss. When Swami Vivekananda came to Sri Ramakrishna, and Swami Vivekananda was not a believer in Mother Kali, he believed in God without form, the God of the Brahman, he was a worshipper of Brahma Samas, and then when he came to Sri Ramakrishna and prayed him instead of going to the Mother Kali's temple. Say, I have so much problem, you do something. Knew that Sri Ramakrishna has power to bless, and by his blessing, the thing will be all right. Nothing was working for him. Again, this Mahamaya's play. Mother Kali was giving trouble. Out of our grace, was giving trouble to Swami Vivekananda. In fact, Holy Mother said, all the troubles in our life is the grace of Divine Mother. So only we have to see that as the grace. So that is the thing. And he says, oh, all your trouble in life because you don't accept Mother. I can't. Then he said, can you pray for me that way? So Sri Ramakrishna said, I can't pray for such things. You go and pray. And said, whatever you pray, Mother will grant it. If you look, Sri Ramakrishna saying, whatever you pray to her, Mother will grant. Then why don't you pray? Because I can't pray that such thing. But he assured Narendra Nath, if you pray for food, clothing, little comfort, that Mother will give you. That is assured. Swami Vivekananda goes, totally forgets, what did I come for? Because, why did he forget? He was a very intelligent person. We all know how intelligent is Swami Vivekananda. And great memory. How could such a person forget the greatest need of his life? He had to look after his family. He was the eldest son. And the mother, sisters, brothers, all were there. So he forget. Why did he forget? Because when he went there, he saw Mother Kali. What form he saw, it is not described. Whether he saw in the form of Mother living with our sword and all those things, saw light as Sri Ramakrishna saw the presence of the Divine, that Brahman itself there, that Satchidananda is there, he is in the midst of that Satchidananda, he didn't describe. And he said, whatever I have experienced, that is a secret which will die with me. He never told to anyone that what experience he had. And then he asked for Viveka Vairagya and Bhakti, Jnana and Bhakti, and uninterrupted vision of yours. He wanted to be with God. He saw that there is no difference between Mother Kali and the Brahman that he is worshipping. Of course, that is there. Mother Kali is the ultimate reality which he worshipped as Brahman. So that realization came to Swami Vivekananda. It is inseparable from the Brahman. Brahman and Kali are one. That definitely Swami Vivekananda had. So far he was also like Totapuri, denying this created aspect, this Prakriti aspect of the universe. Only Purusha is the reality. We have to go beyond that through the prayers, some prayers of Upanishad. Then he further, Sri Ramakrishna asked, did you ask what you wanted? Sri Ramakrishna, how did he know? He will not ask. He said, oh my God, I forgot. He said, what person you are? Go again and ask. Again went, again same experience. Again he asked for something else which he didn't plan to ask. All this spiritual aspect of reality, make me pure, make me devoted, give me knowledge, give me your presence, feel, I may feel. Like that thought. Only spiritual, no material prayer. Sri Ramakrishna again rebuked him. What a person you are. There is so much need for that. Go and ask. Mother is ready to give what you will ask. He went there with consciousness now third time. I know what I need and what I should ask. And then also he didn't ask. Then what did he ask? Give me knowledge. Whatever he asked, first time he asked the same thing again. She came back. Sri Ramakrishna, did you ask this time? Did you remember? Yes, I remember. Did you ask? No, I couldn't ask. Why couldn't you ask? Oh, I was in the presence of God, asking for a few grains and clothes and little material comfort, and that seemed like very negligible thing. So I asked for purity, devotion, knowledge, and all the spiritual qualities I asked. That is worth asking from God. And he compares, when one goes to king, does one ask some potatoes and some eggplant? Can you give me 2 eggplants and 5 potatoes? To king if you go, you ask for diamond if you have to ask. Some diamond, some house, some big property, some nice cars. King, he can give anything to you. Why do you ask potato and eggplant? That's why I did not ask that. He was conscious this time. Then he came to Sri Ramakrishna and said, I didn't ask, but you will have to do. He had full faith in Sri Ramakrishna, but before this had no faith in Mother Kali. It was a strange thing. He never went to Kali temple for this 3 years when he used to come to Dakshineswar. Now, after that, Sri Ramakrishna said, don't worry, there will be no dearth of food and simple clothing for your family. That really he blessed. He could have done first itself. And he was so happy that Naren has accepted Kali. Kali and Brahman together. Without that accepting half. You see only one side of the coin and say that is the coin. What is the other side? You have to accept both. Can you say I will get only one side of the coin and not the opposite side? You cannot get. It is all together. Mother and Kali and Brahman are always together. Now that was, and Swami Vivekananda later said, Mother Kali took advantage of my trouble and then she made me slave for all my life. After that, he became instrument in the hand of Mother Kali, Sri Ramakrishna, whatever you say. And he realized that Kali and Mother are not separate, Swami Nikhilanandji said. He must have seen Sri Ramakrishna there in place of Mother Kali, or must have felt the presence and realized that Sri Ramakrishna and Mother Kali are same. He never died, but they guess. Otherwise, why he again said to Sri Ramakrishna that you will have to do the thing, and Sri Ramakrishna said, okay, there will be no doubt of that. That is the story, how this. And he said, because you do not accept Kali, that's why this all trouble, worldly trouble. If you don't accept the Divine Mother, then this trouble will be there. Like Sri Krishna saying to Arjuna, I take your responsibility, like Sri Ramakrishna also took all the responsibility of Swami Vivekananda. Sri Ramakrishna and Mother Kali became one, there is no doubt about that. Swami Sri Ramakrishna says, one must propitiate the Divine Mother, the primal energy, in order to obtain God's grace. God Himself is Mahamaya, who deludes the world with her illusion and conjures the magic of creation, preservation and destruction. She has spread the veil of ignorance before our eyes. We can go into the inner chamber only when she lets us pass through the door. Leaving aside, we see outer objects, but not that eternal being, Satchit Ananda. So Sri Ramakrishna goes on saying the Shakti has 2 aspects, Vidya Shakti and Avidya Shakti, Vidya Maya and Avidya Maya. Both belong to Mother Kali. And through Vidya Maya, going through Avidya Maya, all that we see and we have desires, so many go. Going through this, we have to reach the Vidya Maya, the Sattva Guna, through this all, Tamo Guna and Raja Guna, we have to elevate ourselves to go to Vidya Maya. Vidya Maya is purity, love for God, kindness. That we have to reach, we have to transform ourselves. Uddharet Atmana Atmanam, that Sri Krishna says. You should try to transform yourself by yourself. By yourself, not possible. Then come to Mother. Sri Ramakrishna made it more easy. Come and pray to Mother, and that Mother will help you. And they will reach Avidya Maya. from avidya to vidya maya and from vidya maya to beyond maya by the grace of mahamaya. Without her grace, that doesn't happen. So, saisha prasanna varada ninam bhavati muktaye. By her grace alone, when she is pleased and by her grace alone, the human being are liberated. Ninam bhavati muktaye. So, Sri Ramakrishna said, pray to the Divine Mother with a longing heart, as he had. And he said, force your demands on the Divine Mother. That is the beauty of Divine Mother. Divine Mother, when we consider our own mother, and Sri Ramakrishna gives many examples. One child was asking, Mother, please give me some money to buy kite, money to buy kite. So, and he said, what, why are you asking me? Ask your father. So, he said, Mother, please give me. No, I won't go to him. Please give me. And she was saying, asking again and again. And then mother finally, she had to relent to that. And when there opened her locker with cut, cut, cut the sound, and he took out some few coins and gave him to buy kite. So when you pester mother, then the thing is done. Mother says, Mother, can you give me money? Mother will say, no, ask your father. But you should not let mother go like that. Mother, you'll have to grant me that what is needed for me to be free from this maya. So you have to grant me all those things. And when you force your demands on the Divine Mother, that mother will help. Swami Vivekananda also used to say, Mother, you will have to do this for me. Then why did you give me birth in this human in the human form and give me little interest for you? So you must give me knowledge and devotion to you, uninterrupted vision of yours, uninterrupted experience of your presence, practice of the presence of God. That is what we have to demand, not only pray, but demand from the Divine Mother. So mother becomes very happy, really he wants. That is the sign of yearning for devotion. One must have for God the yearning of a child. That is the story that Sri Ramakrishna had said. So to read the truth of Vedanta, the way is through the Divine Mother, this manifested universe, the manifested Brahman as God, whatever form you do. Divine Mother is not only Mother Kali. Mother Kali includes all the incarnation of God. Those all by Kali in Sri Ramakrishna's term, Kali is whole creation and all God like Krishna and Rama and Buddha and Jesus, all are different forms of that Kali. By the grace of Kali, they all are born here to teach mankind. Kali is the Jagat Guru. Because Brahman is not acting. So why Shankara and Jesus and all great prophets come to guide us? Sri Ramakrishna, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, all they come by the plan of Mother Kali, the divinity that which Sri Ramakrishna calls Mother Kali, who is the ultimate divinity to which we can interact, which we can transact our prayer, we can place our prayer, and also we have to place our demands to her. You have to do this thing. Again, while demanding, we have to be careful whether we are under the sway of avidya maya and want worldly things, or we have attained ourselves to vidya maya and want the spiritual prayers from the Divine Mother. But whatever we want, we can force her and say, Mother, you have to grant me that, and Mother will grant, say that. So if we want the Vedantic knowledge where there is no external consciousness or internal consciousness, only with adrishtam abhyadesham ekarpa pratyasaram prapancho pasmam shantam shivam advaitam chaturtham. The fourth we want, go to the Divine Mother. Mother, you will have to grant me that. You are the giver of knowledge. Please do that. I want that. If we have yearning for that, Mother will set aside her veil power, the maya, and let you see what is the truth. The hole in the wall will be created, and you can see the meadow. And if you want to go and enjoy how the fresh air is in the meadow, you can go through that hole. The whole earth are all avatars that Mother has sent us, all the prophets that Divine Mother creates for us. And you go there, after you go there as who said, when the Sufi poet, Sufi saint said, the truth is beyond a curtain. And when you remove the curtain and go beyond the curtain, then you are not there. You want to experience what is beyond the curtain. When you reach there, you are not there. Your individuality is not there. You have become one with the truth. So that we can demand to Mother, grant me the knowledge of Satchidananda, Brahma, Jnana, Atma. I want to know who I am. And Mother will, when she is propitiated, she is pleased, she will grant that Saisha Prasanna Varada Ninam Bhavati Muktaye, Mukti from all ignorance, bondage, from all Maya is possible by the grace of the Divine Mother. So, thank you very much for attending today's this class. Is Menaka there? No, Menaka, the second mercy, I think. So, next week we have, next Sunday we have AGM, Annual General Meeting. So, if you have not sent your proxy, please send either by email or by mail. Or if you want to join, you are welcome. We start at 11 a.m. It's about 1.5 hour to 2 hour program. So that is the AGM where you will know and support about the Vedanta Society of Toronto. It's regarding the our institution. There will be no Sunday service next Sunday. So you are welcome to attend online or in person. And also if you have not, you are not attending in person, only attending online, please send your proxies by email or by scanned copy or by mail the form that has been sent to you in our mailing newsletter, along with newsletter. We need that to meet the quorum. Without that, meeting cannot be held. That's very important for our members to please see that you have already sent that. And with this, I chant the closing chant, then we'll have the correction. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Tat Sat Sri Ram Krishna Arpanamastu Jai Sri Guru Maharaj Ji Ki Jai Jai Mahamai Ki Jai Jai Swami Ji Maharaj Ji Ki Jai Jai Ganga Mai Ki Jai Jai Bhagavan Buddha Ki Jai Jai Isha Musa Ki Jai Sarva Staratu Durgani Sarvo Bhadrani Pashyatu Sarvasat Buddhimapnotu Sarvas Sarvatra Nandatu Hari Om Tat Sat. May all be freed from dangers. May all realize what is good. May all be actuated by noble thoughts. May all rejoice everywhere. Om Peace, Peace, Peace.